people who were told they were gifted growing up. How did you deal with realizing that you were pretty average? It doesn't matter how smart you are, you always hit the level where you meet people who are equally smart, or good looking, or athletic, or savvy, and when you measure up the competition and see that they're as good as you or better, you'll come to realize, being smart just gets you a seat at the table. Raw talent, no matter how little or how much, can only accomplish so much. At some point, you will be forced to ask the question, what can I do, and what do I want to do with that? The answers can lead you to a fulfilling life, at pushing your capabilities and achieving things you've fought for, but you have to find the answers first. My dad always said, I don't know who he was quoting, if you're the smartest person in the room then you're in the wrong room. Haha, I didn't deal with it very well at all. I went to a private school, I was in the gifted class all through high school, always told I was smart and creative. I was shocked when just showing up and winging it wasn't good enough anymore. I had a breakdown at university, dropped out and was depressed doing as little as possible with my life for years. Instead of realizing that everyone needs to make mistakes and work hard on things to grow, I was like, oh, I guess I was wrong and I'm actually stupid. Guess I'll figure out how to live life as a dumb idiot. I think telling someone their value is their intelligence is a really unhealthy mindset to encourage, especially in a kid. It's not how I choose friends. It's not what makes someone good to work with. It's not gonna mean someone is well adjusted or happy. I fricked up my life till I was 27 or 28. Got mostly clean and mostly on the level. Got a good job and escaped 5 generations of poverty. Being pretty average is great. While I didn't really have the struggles with addiction you imply here, it was also around 27 or so that I got my crap in order to move forward with my life. I wonder how common that is. To be honest, it was a massive relief. I'd gone through school as the clever one, and when I went to uni, finding out that I was solidly mediocre was a blessing. All of a sudden, I could be myself. I didn't need to worry about doing the best in exams or getting a first. I enjoyed my time, got a very average 2.1, and now have a fun job where there's no pressure to be gifted. It was a bit of a relief when people dropped their expectations of me. I'm not trying to change the world, I am just trying to be happy for myself. Posting thing, because honestly, coming to terms that I wasn't some super intelligent genius sucked. I always thought I'd be able to do complex computer stuff or maybe build a spaceship, but I'm nowhere near that level. I've found my own strengths now, and I'm actually much happier now that my ego isn't super inflated by adults commenting on how mature and gifted I was. That kind of praise killed my motivation to study, because I thought I would just know things automatically. I'm in uni now, but it's because I worked really hard for it, and learning those study habits I didn't develop as a kid really kicked my butt for a while. Kudos for still hanging on. A lot of people give up and just believe they are flawed or made some serious mistake. It keeps going downhill ever since elementary school. I haven't been able to deal with it. It's my depression and lack of motivation that's been stopping me from being my best. It's a hard spiral to get out of. Since childhood, my parents encouraged me to exercise, so I tried a lot of sports, and in most of the places I went to, I'd hear that I was talented or that I was an easy learner. Turns out, I'm nothing special. The thing that I noticed was that when I started something, I would dive heads deep in it. I would go to practice, come back home and watch videos about whatever I was doing. My world and total attention would become that one thing. I wish someone had encouraged me to exercise. I feel like gifted program in my schools gave me a lot more hands-on applicable knowledge than non-gifted. Not only did we have to take the above average class load, but we had extracurricular studies which benefited the community, helped us innovate new ideas and learn new skills, and help us understand what learning style is best for us. I feel like I was unbelievably lucky to have a school that cared about their gifted program, and that many schools just kind of check it off just to have it and just hit state required minimum standards. Although it sucks being that guy, it depends on your personality. I took it well because it helped me realize that I don't need 3 PhDs to prove my potential. Looking back, I'm not sure how I made it into the group. I always knew I was the least gifted out of the group of us who were in the gifted and talented program. When we got into high school, I had the lowest grades in the group. Yay. Low 90s were my thing. But that's not anything special, especially in a school renowned for its academic program. I never made it into the top 10 for grades. However, I'd always score in the 97th to 99th percentile for the standardized testing. Unlike others in the group, I didn't possess any natural talents or any drive for extra knowledge. I liked extracurricular activities and being a leader, but that's also because I was a big fish in a small pond. I suppose I demonstrated analytical and leadership skills. I've done well in life in terms of get degrees and professional jobs. I don't earn as much money as I could since I don't like enjoy the stress that comes with the money. My life is consistently above average. I do pretty well at things I try but never amazing. I cannot say I've ever excelled at anything. While I'm happy where I am, I do wonder if it's because I don't apply myself enough or if it's because I just never found my thing. Reality hit me like a ton of bricks when I finished college. All through school, I was top of the class, valedictorian, summa cum laude, etc. Turns out I wasn't really gifted at all. I was just really good at jumping through all the hoops of the education system. Give me an assignment, and exam, I will ace it. When it came to forging my own path out in the real world, where there is no syllabus and no one cares about your GPA, I got overwhelmed with how clueless I actually was about everything. Struggled with that imposter syndrome for many years and stayed pretty stagnant. Although I'm still a classic good employee, while I watched my peers move way ahead of me in their careers, I eventually figured out my workplace was pretty toxic and things have improved with a new job and setting career goals for myself. But yeah, I'm average. Whoa, I'm not sure I've ever related to a comment as much as this one, especially regarding imposter syndrome. Have you ever heard the phrase, if you're the smartest person in the room, you're in the wrong room? I think for me, when I was in K-12, it's hard to find the right room. But when you get to college or choose a career, there are suddenly a lot more options for rooms to choose from. One of my goals in life is to always be moving forward, constantly improving in some way. Frequently, this means increasing my knowledge or technical skill level, especially since I'm in my mid-20s. So although it's been difficult to find the right room, it's much more gratifying, since that means that I'm surrounded by people I can learn from and with. I guess what it comes down to in the end is your attitude. Sure, it sucks not being handed things because you're viewed as some sort of elite. But I enjoy feeling like I earned something through effort and determination, so it's worth those occasional moments of doubt. I eventually grew out of that too and realized I'm not just average. I got through high school and college without ever learning to study or focus. So once I started my first real job and had to deal with failing for the first time, it made me feel like I was stupid and everyone had been lying to me my whole life to make me feel better. Eventually though, I realized that wasn't true either. If you're identified as gifted as a kid, you probably are. But rather than having to overcome difficulty learning things, you have to overcome difficulty with actually doing things instead of skating by despite being a lazy freak, he said, while Andre did at work. I knew from the start. I've always been a gifted speaker and fairly logical, so people thought I was intelligent. It's actually really annoying because I have never gotten the help I needed in life. People always assume I have motivational issues or distractions because I'm a smart guy. My intelligence and ability has never been questioned. I didn't deal with this well at all. I gave up in school because I got too far behind without getting help. So I straight up quit after 9th grade and started working. I wasn't going to waste my time anymore. But I sometimes wonder if I had gotten the help I needed then, perhaps I would have been able to make a better life for myself. Haha, this is definitely me. On a roll every year in elementary school and middle school up until I hit geometry. I just couldn't wrap my head around the subject and spent so much time trying to get it that my other subjects suffered. Fell to below average. Failed geometry anyways. Got to high school. I think I ended up failing another math class or two along the way. Went from a perfectly performing student to one of the bad students, and that kind of shaped my social expectations. In high school I figured I wasn't one of the smart kids, so I may as well be one of the fun kids. Started smoking and drinking. Luckily none of those habits ever got out of hand. Eventually I realized, or maybe someone older and wiser than me told me that schools and grades really don't matter all that much and no one really gives a crap if you're above below average because we all have strengths and weaknesses. You don't judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree. You know, I know some academically idiotic people who are just so talented in other parts of their life, to the point that it's legitimately inspiring. Anyways, I did graduate high school by just barely passing my math requirements, but I found my passion in web technologies because of an awesome teacher who gave me a ton of opportunities. I went to college for interactive media, and after I got past the first two awful years where we had to do general education bulls, speech, math, civics, literature, etc., and got into the stuff I was interested in, college became easy as heck. In fact, I legitimately loved my last 2 years of college, and by senior year I was back on honor roll for the first time since 6th grade. Got a job in my field before graduation rolled around, and now I get to go to a job I love every day. It was a lot of work to get here, yeah, but it was worth it. Long story short, you are gifted. No one lied to you. Just not at the things that some schools or institutes or teachers think you should be gifted at. I think I needed this. Thanks for sharing. I had a teacher parent growing up. I was frequently told that I had an above average IQ and I should go study and stuff. I was a lazy person and didn't study a lot. I dropped out of no less than 3 higher education courses, schools that would have been my ticket to studying at an university. Why didn't I study? Because I was sure I wouldn't need any degrees in my dream job. Guess what? I was right. I realized I was just above average, not super intelligent. However, what I have extra in smarts I lack in social skills, but that's a common problem for everyone outside of the norm. See, I cold studied heaps in high school, got a good ATAR, Australian GPA, but I settled for an average ATAR in social skills instead. Something tells me the social skills are far more important for real life : I was told that when I was younger, currently in my first year of engineering at one of the hardest schools in Canada. Still don't have study skills, but I'm doing pretty good. Figure I'm fricked when I need to actually start doing work. Let's see how it goes. I quit engineering school 2 years in. I'm now a manufacturing engineer, and let me tell you, it's way easier. I'm not really doing design work, but if you know the basics of sensors, you'll be fine in the beginning. It's odd, honestly. I was told I was gifted because I picked things up really quickly, and I still do. But I've always lacked the motivation to stick with one thing long enough to be excellent at it. I typically change jobs every 18 months, and I'll stick with a hobby for 6 months or so before getting bored. I'm average above average at a whole lot of different things, but I'm not truly exceptional at anything. I don't think that you are average in that situation when you feel like you're average. For most part, the world around you is average, and being gifted is kind of a bummer since you can't really work with that. Getting through college, for example, can be more difficult if you have a unique mind that hinders your progress and you fall behind. That's not because you're dumber than the others, but because that institution doesn't work well with your way of thinking. It's more difficult because it's mainstream and you have to adapt more than others. Using your giftedness, however, can be used in every job there is. It's just not very career-changing. And many jobs don't have the ceiling high enough to get a good idea going. You're basically a golden cog. No machine in the world is purely made out of golden cogs. So there's no use for your specialness. All in all, you're just going to be another cog in the machine. I got into the workforce, aka the real world, and realized that I actually am gifted like they told me. Just turns out that gifted doesn't mean being some brilliant genius like I thought. It just means being ahead of the hordes of mouth-breathing frickin' idiots. Can you read instructions and figure out a new machine or process in a reasonable time frame? Congratulations, Mr. Gifted. You're ahead of 70% of the general public. I think it's about realizing that there's a lot of gray area between pretty smart and genius. I'm a pretty smart guy. I feel like I've met some dumb M's, so I'm at least doing better than them. But being pretty smart doesn't get you a Nobel Prize, right? It just means you're not a dumb mother. So, I think I'm doing alright. I think the whole mindset of gifted kids is flawed, though. We should be rewarding effort and teaching kids that hard work, and not natural ability, does amazing things. A lot of teachers, I feel, mistook neuroplasticity for intelligence in secondary school and early university, and the results they groomed me for didn't come in. All in all, I dealt with it pretty easily. I was a lot more fine with being an average student and a disappointment than they were, it seems. Eventually, I just told one of them what I think the problem was and that they had mistaken plasticity for intelligence, and the teacher agreed. In the end, I wasn't as intelligent as it had assumed at first, but I just learned new things really quickly, which is different. Plasticity has its own advantages though, but I ended up being a fairly average programmer. Not the top grade mathematician they expected me to be, but I guess it's nice that I can learn how to handle the borrow checker in a couple of hours whilst a lot way smarter than I take weeks to master it. They can just do more impressive things with it once they do and actually innovate whilst I'm just a code monkey that does simple stuff. Took a long time to come to terms that I'm not a genius, and I'm just now beginning to be able to realize the things I am gifted at. That being said, people don't just tell you that you're gifted for the laughs, at least in my opinion. If they say it, they see something in you. Figure out what that something is, capitalize on it, and ride that bad boy all the way to Mars. I would always say, it's how you use the gifts you're given that matters. Then, as now, I just quietly apply myself without wanting any undue attention. I pretty much knew it was balls from the beginning. My mother and at least one teacher told me that I was smarter than average and that I could do anything I put my mind to. However, my grades were always bad and I was very lazy and uninterested in school. My entire public school experience was waiting for the day to be over. 18 years or so of looking out the window and trying not to be called on by the teacher. Once I got to college, it was more of the same for the first year. I hated it. Later, I actually tried to succeed in school and the results were pretty amazing. I made the honor roll several times and was even featured in the college newsletter as an outstanding student. Turns out that I have the level of intellect required to accomplish middle of the road prosperity with a regular butt job and a regular butt house. The truth is that we are all kind of smart and everyone has a certain level of ability. If any halfway motivated person tries hard to get something they want, they will probably get it, to some degree. I was misclassed as gifted. I think I had learning disabilities, difficulties that just masked things, if I'm honest. I could hardly read, but could do math and logic very well for my age. And my guess is all my effort went into the maths, which I could connect with, made me look smart at least to whoever was evaluating me. Result was horrible. Was sent to special schools for the gifted where even the teachers made fun of me cause I could hardly read a sentence, and told me I just had to focus on it and was lazy and it should click given what else I was capable of. I mean, I learned I am gifted at standardized tests. I did great at those, which is why grade school was a piece of cake. I did okay. I think it helped that I was in a gifted program and saw myself on par with a bunch of my classmates, and I realized at a young age that while I was gifted in language, I was rubbish in maths. As an adult, yes, I'm average, but I'm also gifted in so many ways and I see how other people in my life are gifted in their own ways. It's actually quite beautiful. My thing is, I was told that I was gifted, but I always felt average. I caught onto some things a little faster than my friends, but then I got enrolled in this gifted program in second grade where most of the other kids had home situations that were more stable, and more support from their families. And I struggled there. I was one of the two kids in that class who came from poor families, and the other kids gave us a lot of crap for being poor. I tried to skip a lot, miss the bus, etc. But it never really worked. I basically went from being one of the smartest kids in the regular room where all my friends were, to being one of the dumbest kids in the gifted room where I was being made fun of, which definitely fricked with my self-esteem. Still, I think the bigger issue was watching my family come to terms with me being average. I remember hitting middle school and struggling with math for the first time. We have to deal with letters now. We were at something with my family, and my mom was talking about my school struggles with my grandparents, and right in front of me she said, "I don't understand. Harold used to be so smart." The crap sat with me. I still have a lot of trouble with imposter syndrome, and I'm almost incapable of saying that I'm good at anything, even things that I probably am good at. I still get told that I am 10 years into my career, but I still don't feel like I am. I feel like I'm just good at Google. I just thought I was an underachieving gifted person. Thanks for ruining my illusions. So, I guess I just realized it and yeah, I'm pretty bitter about the whole thing. Pretty great actually, if I'm average, which I largely am, then the world has a lot of people better than me and that's pretty great for the world. I love your optimism. Been hitting a rough patch lately because I feel like I've been failing, but that kind of idea makes me feel better somehow. As someone labeled gifted growing up, I'm so sick of people who developed bad study habits blaming the label on them becoming average adults. Being gifted just means you understand things more quickly or in other ways than the other students. This could be for a multitude of reasons: advanced reading comprehension, unique ways of thinking, higher spatial thinking, etc. I still find in my day-to-day life that I think differently than most adults, but I wouldn't say it's inherently because I have a higher intelligence. You can be gifted for a lot of reasons. I'm sorry you're average though. I still am. I mean, I get that I'm gifted. I'm just also depressed and unmotivated, which is what I've been since around 8th grade. That's when my straight A's started plummeting. I almost didn't graduate high school because I was failing the last science credit that I needed. Ended up bouncing around different majors in college, had to take a medical withdrawal when I failed a few courses. All my life I've been told, "You're so smart, if you only applied yourself," and I agree with them. I wish I had the self-discipline and motivation that other people have. Just even a little bit, I might have done something with my life. But now I'm 35, and I work a boring dead-end job that pays about a third of what I should be earning at my age. All that wasted potential. I was the smartest kid in middle school. I was one of the smarter kids in high school. I was a completely average kid in college. I got into the real world and realized I am completely below average intelligence, and most days I have no idea how I managed to dress myself and not drool all over the place. I work at a place where pretty much everyone here is more intelligent than I am. I do complex computer stuff, have lots of geeky friends and love it. I also found a new appreciation for boring stuff since now my work is complex, so I keep my leisure simple and fully enjoy it. I was gifted as a kid, but I think it was more because of expectations. I was reasonably bright, and at school I managed to stay in the top 5 in the class with very little studying. But I also managed to never achieve anything. Despite being in the top 5, I never received a single award or commendation at school. Good, not good enough. I hung out with smart friends. At university it all came crashing down. Being reasonably bright was not good enough to succeed without work. And I failed badly. I've never made any great impact on anything, though I did eventually learn how to study and got a degree. I've pretty much come to terms with it, and I make the best of my knowledge and abilities by making an effort to work hard where it'll help me succeed. But I know I have huge flaws. I'll never be the best at anything, but I can be very persistent at doing something decently. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.